Greetings. If you are Muslim, I invite you and even challenge you to listen to this entire video. Alright, back to another grocery list from Deedat's Combat Kit. Contradictions in the Bible. A. The Lord tempted David, 2 Samuel 24:1, or Satan provoked David, 1 Chronicles 21:1. First, one needs to understand only the Quran attempts to generate credentials based on quote-unquote lack of contradiction. Surah 482. Do they not consider the Quran? If it was from any other than Allah, they would surely have found in there a lot of discrepancy and contradictions. This is essentially the naked assertion of the assumption. Assume it is from something called Allah, then you must prove it is not, and the proof must be discovery of irrefutable and undeniable internal contradictions. The hard part, then, is convincing a Muslim a contradiction is in fact a contradiction. They simply deny a contradiction can even exist, therefore any accusation cannot be a real contradiction. In fact, Muslims will add to the Quran to change the text to fit an interpretation that they think eliminates the contradiction. Example 1. The first Muslim, Surah 6, 163. He hath no associate, this am I commanded, and I am the first of the Muslims. So, Mohammed says he is the first person called a Muslim. But then we have this gem, Surah 5, 111. This is allegedly Jesus speaking. And recall what time I revealed to the disciples, believe in me and my apostle, they said. We have believed and bear thou witness that verily we are Muslims. So this now claims the disciples of Jesus were Muslims 600 years before Islam was invented, which means long before Mo claimed to be the first, there were other Muslims. Muslims fix this contradiction by adding to the Quran via liberal verbal expansion of his, the, their group, of my group. So it reads, and I am the first of my group of the Muslims. This childish deception is rather brilliant. They can now have as many first Muslims as they want. Of their group fixes all of them. Since Moses is claimed by assertion to be a Muslim, he would be the first of his tribe, his group of Jews in Egypt. Since Abraham is claimed by assertion to be a Muslim, he would be the first of his tribe, his group. Since Adam is claimed by assertion to be a Muslim, he would be the first of his tribe, his group, humanity. See how this open-ended addition to the Quran works. It is an illogical and deceptive gift that keeps on giving. Understand this strategery of virtual addition and reinterpretation is common and widespread. The final dodge, when you nail a Muslim down, is to declare you must read it in the original Arabic. If you think something is a contradiction, it must be the translation, the bad language, causing it. You, and all the translators, are just not capable of understanding the allegedly clear Quran. But I digress. The Lord tempted David, 2 Samuel 24:1, or Satan provoked David, 1 Chronicles 21:1. Understand, an antagonist is not seeking understanding or a harmonization of the scriptures. An antagonist only seeks to attack, undermine, and discredit the scriptures as the word of God, our Creator. If we are seeking understanding, we will look for a rational meaning of each scripture so they harmonize. 2 Samuel 24:1 and 1 Chronicles 21:1. 2 Samuel was written between 1010 BC and 970 BC. 1 Chronicles was written between 1003 BC and 970 BC. So these two books have contemporaneous overlap. By both, the date of the census is around 979 BC. Let's look at 2 Samuel. 2 Samuel 24:1. Again, the anger of the Lord burned against Israel, and he stirred up David against them, saying, Go and take a census of Israel and Judah. The word stirred up there is 5496. Suth, or sooth. You can see it in yellow on the right. Of the many translation options, stirred seems to be one of the least negative toward the actor, in this case, God. What I do not see in all these possible translations of the word is tempted. Yet somehow that is the word Deedat invents. So this is not even cherry-picking. The Lord tempted David. 2 Samuel 24:1. Again, the anger of the Lord burned against Israel. Jehovah God was angry. That much is clear. His anger burned. Christians believe God has the ability to control everything that happens. Some go so far to believe God, in fact, controls or causes everything that happens. That is a debate well beyond this video. Again, the anger of the Lord burned against Israel, and he stirred up David against them, saying, Go and take a census of Israel and Judah. This verse does not indicate the mechanism by which God, quote, stirred up David, unquote. Was it by the Holy Spirit? Was it by a lying spirit in the mouth of David's prophets? Was it by his nagging wife? Was it by itching powder in his shorts? Was it by Satan? I'm pretty sure it was not itching powder in David's shorts. Beyond that, we know nothing. Or Satan provoked David. Let's look at 1 Chronicles. 1 Chronicles 21:1. Satan rose up against Israel and incited David to take a census of Israel. Huh, same Hebrew word. Again, rather than use a commonly translated word like incited, you can see it here on the bottom right, Deedat plays fast and loose and inserts a more aggressive pseudo-synonym. Satan provoked David, 1 Chronicles 21:1. Here are some synonyms of provoke. I've colored some in red. Actuate, affront, aggravate, agitate, anger, animate, annoy, antagonize, arouse, awaken, badger, bait, begin, beset, bother, bring about. Provoke includes an element of anger in the subject being acted upon, implying David was angry when he caused the census. Just an observation how Deedat changes anything and everything to support his jihad against God's word. Is there a coherent explanation to this seeming contradiction? Sure, and it does not require inserting words, like Islamic dodges of Quranic contradictions. Where the Bible is silent, we should not add words. What we must do, however, is to take the full counsel of the Word of God. Has God ever allowed Satan to take or perform actions? Sure. See Job. Has God ever allowed a lying spirit to act for God's interests? Again, you betcha. 2 Chronicles 18:21. Is Satan a lying spirit? Absolutely. He is a spirit and the father of lies. So is there a contradiction? God was angry. God used Satan, allowed Satan, to lie to David and manipulate him. Satan did not surprise God and make David do something. Satan was no more than, the mechanism. The only contradiction is in Deedat's oversimplified jihad of ignorance. He insists on creating an illogical interpretation where a rational, logical one is obvious. The Lord tempted David, or Satan provoked David. Is this really the first and the best, most damning contradiction Deedat could contrive? Invent? Trumpet! In reality, this pair of associated verses reveals information rather than confusing or invalidating it. But would it even matter if this were potentially a contradiction? As I stated to begin with, only the Quran contrives a self-rationalizing excuse that lack of contradiction is, quote, proof of divine origin, unquote. If this were an actual contradiction, what doctrine would it substantially change, undermine, or invalidate? I suppose Deedat or Islam could attempt to argue this so-called contradiction somehow made Satan equal with God, perhaps indistinguishably equal in control. I'm not saying that is rational or plausible as an argument, which is perhaps why I can't imagine it being foisted by Deedat and Islam. The plausible harmonization is that in God's anger, God used Satan, perhaps as a lying spirit, to manipulate David. Do I see any scriptural evidence that threatens this interpretation? None is coming to mind, which is not to say none exists. Only that as I play the role of Islamic jihadi stooge, I cannot think of a quick and dirty jihad against it. Oh, sure, it does not say God sent Satan. But then it also does not say God said to David, and he stirred up David against them, saying, go and take a census of Israel and Judah. We only assume God said directly to David to go take a census. So is this even a proven contradiction, or just an ill-considered accusation of one? I'll leave the conclusion up to you to decide. Feel free to comment below. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.